Paul and Pete here, and it looks like we got another gift to open. And we have Home Alone for the NES. Someone really wants to torture me for the holidays with a crappy movie-based game. Well, let's get this show on the road. Well, what can I say? This one tells the same fate of all the other NES movie-based games back in the day. The plot of the movie is non-existent, and this one is no exception. Here you play Kevin as you basically run around the house trying to avoid the wet bandits. I'm surprised sensors lived that life back then. Well, you set traps all over to try to trip them up. That's basically it. This game is pure crap, or as my stepson would say, it's garbage. The graphics are just god-awful, and the controls are horrible. The controls are simple. Using the D-pad on the controller, you can go left and right, and up and down stairs. As you aimlessly run around, you see boxes on tables and everywhere. Those are your traps. Push the B button to pick up the trap to be placed somewhere else, or just place the trap right there. The music is really annoying. It sounds like someone tried to do a chip tune but was stuck on the high note. So you get this ear-piercing music. Each time you die, you get to see a static picture of pixelized Kevin holding his face and saying, "Oh no!" Home Alone the movie is a classic and I recommend you watch it. The game, however, not so much. I wish they would have made it easier to drop the trap or give you something as a weapon. In the movie, Kevin had a slingshot. Here, nothing at all. Not even your fists. The graphics are horrible at best. I get it, this was the NES era of games, but some of the stuff that came up back then looked better than this. This reminds me of what a 10-year-old did trying to create pixel art. And another thing, why can you carry some traps to be used later and some traps just drop right off the bat? This made the game even more frustrating, and speaking of them traps, why are they so far apart? The AI is almost unbeatable. You might trap one, but it recoups and chases after you. Well, that's all I have to say on this. Home Alone for the NES is a game that is full of flaws from bad controls, horrible graphics, annoying music. If this was a homebrew game, I would say it's a work in progress. However, this wasn't one, and it shows.
Hey, Paul and Pete here. Just want to thank those that help support the channel, and also give a big shout out to my man CT Gamer for Real. If you like FNAF and Poppy's Playtime fan songs, then you surely like him. He takes them, remixes them, and some of them are pretty damn good. So the link to his channel will be down in the description. Anyway, I'm Paul, with Pete, saying peace out and stay frosty.